and generally fair weather over the western half of the nation, a few clouds stacking up in the mountains, but range from the 40s in Montana to the 70s in southern portions of California, with high pressure dominating. Now, here's the area which had the sunshine today, and that was mainly the area of Portland, Maine, northeast, with Brunswick, Maine, had a lot of sunshine this afternoon. Augusta broke out with some partly cloudy conditions, and that was the area that did experience some of those sunny breaks we talked about yesterday. But as you can see over the rest of the route, it's generally the overcast condition accounting for the gloomy conditions. And the temperatures, we call it isothermal. There's very little change in temperature from one part of the map to the other. As you can see, 35s and 36s quite common on the map. 35 with a light southeast wind in Boston right now. A good time to check your pressure. The barometer reading should be 30.16 inches. The high today, 38. The low, 35. Not much of a range at all. Cloudy skies. The clear spot in Maine is dwindling right now. So the forecast goes like this. It's short and perhaps not so sweet. If you don't like this weather, it's going to continue for tonight, tomorrow, tomorrow night, and Tuesday. Generally gray. If we do see the sun at all, it'll be a bonus. It'll be very, very brief. And there's a chance from time to time there might be a few lonely snowflakes, a little drizzle coming down here and there, especially later tomorrow and early Tuesday. Northeast and northerly winds not too strong, and temperatures will range from near 30 at night to as high as near 40 during the day. So that's it. In a nutshell, one frame, short, not so sweet. Maybe we'll get a little more in the way of sunshine on Wednesday, if you can hold out that long. We
best,
have no choice.
Best you can do, huh?
That's all I can do for now. We'll try again at 11.
Okay. Hour. Thanks, Landry. Everybody's talking basketball and the pairings around the building today, huh?
The unlikeliest of trios tonight, David, to talk about the Celtics, Fresno State, and Ball State.
A lot of basketball. And we'll have highlights and all the details when we come back. I was down at the Garden today. It took about three quarters for class to tell. I kept waiting for them to break away.
But it finally did, David?
Yeah.
Both contenders had tough opponents this afternoon, and it looked for a while like the Celtics might slip back into first place with Philadelphia, but no dice. Philly had early problems with the Milwaukee Bucks, but they blew them open in the third quarter. And at the Garden, the Celtics overwhelmed the Knicks 115-94. TV-4's Bill Coughlin witnessed the Celtics' 25th consecutive win in Boston. He has this report.
The Knicks overcame an early Celtic lead playing both big men. Marvin Webster, 9 first half points.
Tonight, the Minnesota North Stars are idle, so the Bruins have that game in hand, and that will be this evening. So, David, we have Fresno State and Ball State to contend with this week for Boston College and Northeastern, so we'll do some checking up on those schools, find out where they're from, first of all.
It's hard to keep track. They've expanded the field to, what, 48?
48 teams, and how many? NIT has 30-something. It's incredible.
Yeah. And then they would move on to Wake Forest, right, if they get past Ball State.
That's right.
Okay, good highlights. McHale and Roby both look good today, filling in. I've got to talk to Fitch. We've got a few suggestions for him. We're going to fill him in later on, Bill. So another competition of a different sort today in the New England area. At Sugarloaf Mountain in Maine today, the winner of the World Heavyweight Ski Championship is Bernard Heel, a 385-pound TV repairman from New Jersey. He has to wear double-knit slacks because he says they're the only things he can wear that stretch out. That's our report. We'll be back at 11 o'clock tonight with an update on the forecast, sports highlights, a look at the Bruins, and the NBC Nightly News is next. Good night.